We start our adventure at the Wineport just off the A841. Follow the path to Goatfell Mountain. And if you don't know, this might be a sign to help you. Goatfell Mountain, and it says Goatfell Mountain. Take the first left to the Easceanoch Trail. Which is that one? Big old trees. Cross the bridge and follow the path. Sometimes it can be a bit muddy in places, so be careful. And I can walk in the mud because I've got my boots on. Well, square. There is some sheep over there in a farm field. You might be able to see them if you look very, very, very closely. There they are. I think some of them are lambs. And some of them are sheep. This is the big bridge, and there's a lovely, lovely waterfall.
It's a bit slippery as well.
Lovely waterfall behind me. Here it is. Yeah. this fantastic old bridge with a lovely lake with stable water next to it. When you reach the road, follow it back to the A841. There's lovely views of Glen Rosa just off Castle Drive. Over there. Big old trees. Here's the wild mushrooms. That scoot fell behind the dust. Look at those 5 million-year-old standing stones. Nice and straight. As straight as me. Once you get to the end of Castle Drive, turn left. But be careful, cause there's no pavement for a while. Follow the road until you get to the Wineport. Keep following the road. Past the tea shop and Arran Aromatics, and remember to have a go on Little Grey Fergie. There's Little Grey Fergie at the tea shop. It's a real tractor. Now we're back at the Wineport and have completed our trail. Let's celebrate with an Emperor Biscuit chocolate bar. Eat the biscuit bar, and this is what it looks like. What was I meant to say again? What was the road we go straight across? What were we supposed to say about the road?